as I read the passage. Pollution occurs when waste chemicals and other hazardous substances contaminate or dirty the atmosphere. There are three primary polluting forms: air, water, and land. Wildfires, volcanoes, and industrial chemicals are a few of the primary sources of air pollution. Most air pollution comes from burning fossil fuels. These include coal, oil, and natural gas. Factories, electrical plants, and automobiles burn these fuels for power. The burning of fossil fuels may release ash and soot into the air. It also may release harmful gases. This type of pollution may be seen in the form of smog over big cities. Smog-filled air is hazy or hard to see through. So this was our first paragraph. Now let's read the questions based on the first paragraph. They ask us, what is pollution? What are the three types of pollution? From the passage above, list the three fossil fuels. And they finally ask us, list two reasons for burning fossil fuels. So let's go through the paragraph again. More or less, we're trying to see if we could find and pinpoint the sentences which will give us our answers. So let's start off with the first question. What is pollution? So look at the first sentence. It says, pollution occurs when waste chemicals and other hazardous substances contaminate or dirty the atmosphere. So pollution is what happens when we contaminate or dirty the atmosphere. So let's answer our question. What is pollution? Pollution is when the atmosphere is contaminated. Let's go with the second question. What are the three types of pollution? So let's go back to our first paragraph. The second sentence shows us our answer. There are three primary polluting forms: air, water, and land. So we answer our second question. The three types of pollution are air, water, and land pollution. We must always remember to write full sentences in our answers. Question 3. From the passage above, list the three fossil fuels. So we look for any sentence that may contain the term fossil fuels. So we look at the sentence here. Most air pollution comes from burning fossil fuels. These include coal, oil, and natural gas. So this sentence gives us our answer. So the three fossil fuels coal, oil, and natural gas. Right. Question 4. List two reasons for burning fossil fuels. So we go back to our first paragraph. So we see factories, electrical plants, and automobiles burn these fuels for power. Well, all right. There's our answer. So, fossil fuels, when burnt, power our automobiles, electrical plants, and factories. So we just need two of these. So let's underline these. Fossil fuels are burnt to operate automobiles, and power electrical plants. So I hope you guys are getting familiar with the technique of reading at first, reading questions, and then revisiting your passage to address the questions asked. So we're gonna take a short break, and when we come back, we'll address the rest of the passage.
It's a perfect ball and he's out.
I wish your dreams take flight. Let your determination always shine bright.
Hard work is the key. I'll achieve my dreams. Just you watch and see.
Fill up on possibility.
Dairy Dairy, the milky milk.
You're constantly exposed to viruses and bacteria every day. That's why you should take Daxin Double Action. Its formula of vitamins plus zinc strengthens your body's defenses to fight diseases caused by virus, bacteria, and minor infections. Take with Daxin Double Action every day. It's from Bayer.
We are a blend of heritage and style, all one of a kind. If hair that hates humidity is part of your blend, we have a blend for you. Whole Blend Smoothing Hair Care. Paraben-free, blended with purpose. With rich coconut oil, a legendary smoother, and cocoa butter known to soften. As a whole blend, it brings wholesome nourishment to your one-of-a-kind hair for 24-hour frizz control. Blended makes us shine. Blended makes us better. Whole Blends by Garnier Naturally.
Get the nation's leading newspaper on the go by downloading the Digital Guardian app on your iOS or Android devices now and enjoy our special introductory subscription offer now on the nation's first and best digital paper in an easy-to-read digital format. The Digital Guardian, Trinidad and Tobago's fastest-growing, most subscribed, and most read digital paper. Stay on top with the market leader and don't miss a beat in today's fast-paced world. Go to Apple Store or Google Play and download now.
Welcome back, guys, to GT Lessons on CNC3. I am Brendan Creed, and we're here to address the rest of the comprehension passage. So we just finished paragraph one. For those of you now tuning in, we are about to attempt to answer the questions related to paragraph two and three. Let's go. Air pollution may cause cancer and asthma. Air pollution also leads to acid rain or polluted rain that can harm living things. In addition, air pollution may be a cause of global warming, which is a steady rise in the Earth's average temperature. Finally, air pollution damages a part of the atmosphere called the ozone layer. The ozone layer is important because it protects the Earth against harmful rays from the sun. So, we look at question 5 and 6. Question 5 reads, what are two diseases caused by air pollution? So we can refer to the first sentence in paragraph 2. Air pollution may cause cancer and asthma. So we answer question 5. Two diseases caused by air pollution. Are cancer and asthma. Question 6. What is the purpose of the ozone layer? So we look for the term ozone layer in our second paragraph. We have it here, but there's no definition or description of the ozone layer in this sentence. So you look at the second sentence where they say the ozone layer is important because it protects the Earth against harmful rays from the sun. So we have our answer. The ozone layer protects the Earth against harmful rays from the sun. So we continue with our passage. Some causes of water pollution are easy to see. People dump garbage and sewage into creeks, rivers, ponds, lakes, and oceans. Factories or cities sometimes release oils, poisonous chemicals, and other wastes into water. Another cause of water pollution is the use of chemicals in farming. Farmers use some chemicals as fertilizers or substances added to soil to help crops grow. They use other chemicals as pesticides or herbicides. These are substances that kill pests or weeds. When these chemicals seep into the ground, they may make the groundwater unfit to drink. Chemicals also may drain into rivers and lakes, where they can harm fish and other forms of life. Littering or tossing garbage on the ground is a form of land pollution. Litter can destroy the habitats or homes of plants and animals. The buildup of dangerous chemicals in the ground is another form of land pollution. The chemicals may come from farms or factories. These chemicals can spread to plants and animals. They may even harm people who eat the contaminated plants and animals. So we have come to the end of our passage and we have two more questions that we need to answer. Question 7. Explain what happens when farmers use pesticides and herbicides. So we go back to our passage and look for pesticides and herbicides. So we have them here. Let's read. They use other chemicals as pesticides or herbicides. These are substances that kill pests or weeds. And when these chemicals seep into the ground, they make groundwater unfit to drink. So we answer the question. When farmers use pesticides and herbicides, they seep into the ground. And make groundwater unsafe to drink. Question 8. Suggest two ways in which we can help to stop pollution. And then they say suggest a suitable title for the passage. So we need to go back to our, sorry. We need to go back to our passage and see if we can spot any ways which we can implement to stop pollution. So I see one here where they say people dump garbage and sewage into creeks, rivers, and ponds. So one thing we can do to help stop pollution we can stop dumping our garbage into rivers and well we need to find a second thing we can do. So we stop dumping garbage into rivers, creeks, and ponds. And then they said factories or cities sometimes release poisonous chemicals and other waste into water. We also have farmers using fertilizers, pesticides, or herbicides. We can. So, and farmers can use safer chemicals. That don't affect our drinking water. Sorry. Lastly, they ask us to suggest a suitable title for the passage. Now, I'd like to invite our viewers on Facebook Live. Feel free to send us suggestions on what you think we should name this passage. I have one in mind, but I'd like to hear your thoughts as well.
And bacteria every day. That's why you should take Duxin Double Action. Its formula of vitamin C plus zinc strengthens your body's defenses to fight diseases caused by virus, bacteria, and minor infections. Take with Duxin Double Action every day. It's from Bayer.
We are a blend of heritage and style, all one of a kind. If hair that hates humidity is part of your blend, we have a blend for you. Whole Blend Smoothing Hair Care. Paraben-free, blended with purpose. With rich coconut oil, a legendary smoother, and cocoa butter known to soften. As a whole blend, it brings wholesome nourishment to your one-of-a-kind hair for 24-hour frizz control. Blended makes us shine. Blended makes us better. Whole Blends by Garnier Naturally.
This is more than just music. This is where you find the best of TNT. This is more than just a vibe. This is where Bollywood gets a twist. This is more than just energy. This is Bhangra and Indie Pop 2. This is the mix. This is the life. Lock on or log on now. Sangeet 106.1 FM. This is authentic East Indian radio. This is us.
The fact that they ask the questions, those challenging questions that no other media house would ask. To, you know, shed light on those things that are in the dark, those stories that no one else wants to cover. I grew up reading The Guardian, actually. It's a household name.
About The Guardian, one thing that I like, the human interest stories have increased.
The city investigated pieces on the human trafficking. I find that very interesting.
Sam, you go more in depth.
On sports, especially local sports, and that's one of my highlights for The Guardian.
Yeah, I read The Guardian. The Guardian started coming out, started working. I was a newspaper man.
Guardian.
The Guardian.
The Guardian.
The Guardian.
The Guardian. The Guardian. The Guardian is my first choice.
Receive a free Kindle Fire 7 HD with Alexa features when you purchase any of our highly effective JJ and Friends educational programs. The JTAP Junior Suite for children 2 to 5 years, the JTAP Suite for children 6 to 8 years, and the SEA Suite for students in standards 3 to 5 preparing for the SEA exam. It's the best of both worlds, amazing educational programs and a free Kindle Fire 7. This is a special introductory offer available for a limited time only. Call now 800-READ.
For more on this special offer, join us on Saturdays, 9 a.m. on CNC3.
Welcome back, guys. You're watching GT Lessons on CNC3. And when I left you guys over the last break, I asked you guys to work on some title suggestions for our passage. Now, we got some very good responses from you guys at home. Avril, she gave us two. She said, how we pollute the island and different ways we pollute. Those were two very good suggestions. Latoya gave us the negative effects of pollution, and Josiah gave us causes of pollution. All of these are very good suggestions. I was thinking of saying how we hurt the earth or how we pollute the earth. All of those are along the same line. So try and get creative with your title suggestions. A lot of people would be tempted to just put pollution as their title for this passage, and yes, it gives you the idea of what the passage is speaking about, but at the same time, it's very bland and uninteresting. So try to stay away from those answers for these types of questions. I appreciate all the responses from you guys at home on Facebook, and I invite you guys to keep on giving us your answers. So let's move on to our poem. This is our second comprehension for today. So I invite you guys to read with me. When the birds begin to chirp high up in the trees, when the sun slowly rises to say hello to me, when the streets become busy with people all around, when the cars are zooming all through the town, when the moon says hello and the sun says goodbye, when the stars begin to twinkle like lit in the sky, when the owls finally wake and start to sing their tune, when people are settling down to sleep soundly in their rooms. Anytime, any place, no matter where I go, I think of all the happy things that make my smile grow. The laughter and the joy and all the little things, I love to focus on the positive things that life brings. The Sun Poem. So let's look at our questions so that we know when we're going through what we need to look for in our poem. So question one asks, what time of day is the poet speaking about in stanza one? Question two, what figure of speech is used in stanza one, line two? Can the sun say hello? Give a reason for your answer. What figure of speech is used in stanza two, line two? Question 5. What is a synonym for positive as used in stanza 3? And question 6. Suggest an appropriate title for the poem. So let's address question one. What time of day is the poet speaking about in stanza one? So we go to stanza one. And let's read. When the birds begin to chirp high up in the trees, when the sun slowly rises to say hello to me. So when the sun slowly rises, now. Oh yeah, to say hello. Now, the sun doesn't rise at night. The sun sets at night. So whenever you see somebody speaking about the sun rising, it generally tends to mean they're speaking about the early morning period. So there we have our answer. In stanza one, the poet is speaking about the early morning period. And of course, this can be phrased differently. Some people may say early in the morning. Some people may refer to it as dawn. Question two. What figure of speech is used in stanza one, line two? So this is a very specific line that they refer to. So we need to go back up to stanza one, line two. So we have that right here. So they say, when the sun slowly rises to say hello to me. Now, people may have different answers, but what is the sun? The sun is an inanimate object. But our poet here says the sun slowly rises to say hello to me. Now, I'm not sure if you guys have ever seen a tree, a pack of Lays, a book say hello to anyone. If you have, call Ghostbusters, please. But if an inanimate object is made to do something that a person does, that figure of speech is personification. So in stanza one, line two, poet uses personification. Very big word, write that down. Make sure you spell it correctly. Question three. Can the sun say hello? Give a reason for your answer. So it's a play on question two. No, the sun can't say hello. Why? Because it's an inanimate object and cannot speak. Question four. What figure of speech is used in stanza two, line two? So this is a very specific location again. So let's go to stanza two. Now when dealing with passages, they'll point you to paragraphs. When dealing with poems, they point you to stanzas. So stanza 2, line 2 is right here. Let's read the line. When the stars begin to twinkle like lit in the sky. Now the key to establishing which figure of speech is used is this term right here, like. When two things or phrases are compared using the term like, as, or words such as these, that tends to mean a simile is used. So when the stars begin to twinkle like glitter in the sky, that is an example of a simile. So in this line, of the poem, a simile is used. So similes can be used every day in creative writing, in general. It's figures of speech. So in conversation on a daily basis. Something as simple as he ran as fast as a cheetah, or as fast as Usain Bolt, whichever one is faster. These are examples of similes that can be used every day. What is a synonym for positive as used in stanza 3, line 4? So let's go to stanza 3, line 4. It's not exactly line 4, but they mean this area right here. I love to focus on the positive things that life brings. So let's just read the whole stanza to get an idea of the context in which positive is used. Anytime, any place, no matter where I go, I think of the happy things that make my smile grow. The laughter and the joy and all the little things, I love to focus on the positive things that life brings. So, what is a synonym? A synonym is a word that can be replaced with something, a word that can come into place for another word. So, we look at positive and we need to find words that can replace the word positive and not change the meaning of the sentence. So I invite you guys on Facebook Live to send in some synonyms for positive that we can possibly place in this passage. Now there's one word I'd like you guys to stay away from, and that's the word good. Now good may be able to work in this case, but good is a, let's say it's a general word that can be used in many different sentences or contexts. And it's also, I hate to say it, but it's also a very boring choice. And it would help you as a student to try and stay away from using the adjective good in place of other words. So try to think a little bit about what you may put in place of positive. And 6, suggest an appropriate title for the poem. So I'd like you guys to try your best, give us some ideas as to what you think could be a good title for this poem. And we'll be back shortly after some quick commercials. And I'd like to hear from you guys at home on Facebook. What do you think this poem can be named?
You can get it in the morning. You can get it in the evening too. You can get it in the nighttime. Target Combi's there for you. Yeah, every day so many ways. Target Combi's good up for days. For your breakfast.
breakfast, lunch and dinner. Make sure you choose a winner. Now she want me to eat it up, eat it up, eat it up. Target combi, believe it, cannot refuse it. Eat it up, eat it up, eat it up, eat it. Target corned beef, yeah.
Target corned beef, trusted for over 50 years. Every day, so many ways.
Distributed by AMCO, a subsidiary of Anta Macau.
Tonight.
We need performance, not politics.
David Naked.
We've never had an era of politicians that we can look back and say, yes, they've done well for the country as a whole.
The footballer.
The Caribbean and the African countries would be spectators to the sport.
And the fighter.
The situation in the Lavendale Hills, the situation in the Mondo Hills, it cannot continue.
Tonight on Viewpoint, football's frontline fighter.
How far is Trinidad and Tobago away from exploding?
Traffic reported. You have 2 hours and 55 minutes to your destination. Let's go.
Well, we may not be able to tune you into a morning Grison, but we definitely can keep you company. The morning route, the best way to start your day.
Don't want anyone to get hurt, right? How about we get him some money out of the drawers?
No, I don't care about money. I need to get into the vault.
Catch Manifest Mondays at 8 p.m. only on CNC3.
This is more than just music. This is where you find the best of TNT. This is more than just a vibe. This is where Bollywood gets a twist. This is more than just energy. This is Bhangra and Indie Pop 2. This is the mix. This is the life. Lock on or log on now. Sangeet 106.1 FM. This is authentic East Indian radio. This is us.
The fact that they ask the questions, those challenging questions that no other media house would ask. To, you know, shed light on those things that are in the dark, those stories that no one else wants to cover.
I grew up reading The Guardian, actually. It's a household name.
About The Guardian, one thing that I like, the human interest stories have increased.
See the investigative pieces on the human trafficking. I find that very interesting.
Sam, you go more in depth.
On sports, especially local sports, and that's one of my highlights for The Guardian.
Yeah, I read The Guardian since The Guardian started working. I was a newspaper man.
The Guardian.
The Guardian is my first choice.
I go ring con. Ati doge ilese tu tobi to itun shashon America. Kini ka koko se? Iwo le se nkan to ba wu e. Sugbe mi lo le yan kadanu.
Don't miss Bob Hart's Abby Shola, Sundays at 7:30 p.m. only on CNC3.
Welcome back, guys, to GT Lessons on CNC3. I am Brendan Creed, and we're continuing with our English lesson for today. So, I left you guys to give me some synonyms for positive in the context that it was used. And the sentence it was used in, the part of the poem it was used in, the laughter and the joy and all the little things, I love to focus on the positive things that life brings. Now, we got some responses from you guys. I'll just call out a few. Now, we got optimistic. Optimistic isn't bad, but if you use optimistic in place of positive, positive comes right before things. I love to focus on the optimistic things that life brings. It's a decent replacement. We got happy isn't bad, but very general. We got well, good vibes, but we need a word, not a term. We got joyful. Joyful could work, that's a very good choice. And we got wonderful. So joyful, wonderful, I'll go with optimistic as well. Now, we got some good suggestions for the title for the poem. I'll just read a few for you guys. Diana gave us A Beautiful Dawn. Latoya gave us The Essence of Life. I like that one. I like them all, actually, but a few of them really try to capture the essence of the poem. Suzanne gave us Goodbye Sun, Hello Moon. And Koylan gave us Positive Views, Wonders of the Day. So this poem really tried to grasp that throughout our day many things happen, but it's important to focus on all the little things that make life worthwhile. Or positive, I should say. So a good title for the poem would be, and you would put your title right there. I would name this poem All the Little Things. Something simple and slightly ambiguous to invite the reader to find out more. So for our last comprehension, we have a graphic and we need to answer the questions below based on the graphic given. So those at home and on TV, sorry, those at home and on Facebook Live, I invite you guys to look at the graphic for a minute or so and try to pay attention to the information provided. Alright guys, let's look at the questions asked based on the flyer. Question 1. What is the purpose of the flyer? Question 2. List two activities that may involve team sports. Question 3. When and where will the event be held? Question 4. Do you think the illustrations used in the flyer are suitable? Give a reason for your answer. Question 5. What information is missing from the flyer? And we have some options here. And we invite you guys to participate with us using megaphone for this question. Question 6. Who do you think will be most likely to attend the event and why? Question 7. Do you think the location is sufficient? Give a reason for your answer. Let's look at question 1. What is the purpose of the flyer? So when we look at the flyer, we see that it advertises a family fun day. So the purpose of the flyer. Advertises a family fun day. Question two. List two activities that may involve team sports. Now let's look at all the activities listed here for this fun day. We have face painting, bouncy castle, track and field, water sports, speed cricket, small goal competition, novelty races, and more. Now there are some that there would be possibilities for teams being involved, but two really stand out to me as being team activities. To me, that would be the speed cricket and the small goal competition. Those of you who aren't familiar with small goal, football in a smaller form. Four-a-side, five-a-side, something of that sort. So two activities. That may involve team sports. Speed cricket and the small goal competition. Right, question three. When and where will the event be held? So we go to our flyer and see that they have Saturday the 21st of August 2020 from 9:30 a.m. to 6 p.m. at the Queen's Park Savannah. So this event will be held on Saturday the 21st of August from 9:30 a.m. to 6 p.m. at the Queen's Park Savannah. Question four. Do you think the illustrations used in the flyer are suitable? Give a reason for your answer. Now, when you have these questions where they ask what you think, you can agree or you may disagree. Regardless, you need to explain why you chose either one. So, when we look at the illustrations for this fun day, we see we have a person running, a person swimming, and someone riding a bike. Now, some of you may say yes. I personally, I would say no, strictly because if you were just to see these images, you may associate these images with a triathlon. So someone may see this and think that they're signing up to go to a triathlon instead of go to a family fun day. And to be honest, there are many people who may not see these activities as being strictly fun. This is exercise for men. So I would personally say no. I don't believe that these are suitable. That the illustrations are suitable. Because these images seem closer associated with a triathlon or athletic activity. or athletic event. Now, we invite you guys for the next question to participate and use our megaphone interactive tool to give us what you think the answer may be for question 5. Question 5 asks, what information is missing from the flyer? A, cost. B, the host, or who is hosting or putting on the sports day or family fun day. Contact information. D, all of the above. So what information is missing from the flyer? Question A, answer A, cost. Option B, the host. Option C, contact information. Or D, all of the above. So let's go back up to the flyer and you can look at it for a little while so you can make an informed decision on which answer is correct. Alright guys, the link to submit your answers would be cnc3.co.tt/joincnc3. Yes, guys, you can go to cnc3.co.tt/joincnc3 to submit your answers for question 5, our megaphone interactive question. Alright guys, so for question 5, what information is missing from the flyer? A, cost, there was no cost mentioned on the flyer. B, the host, there was no host mentioned on the flyer either. We don't know who's putting on this family fun day. And there wasn't any contact information either, so the answer would be D, all of the above. So congratulations to our Facebook users viewing on Facebook Live who got the right answer, D, all of the above. So our last two questions, question 6, who do you think will be most likely to attend the event and why? Personally, I believe people with families and young children. Will attend. And lastly, do you think the location is sufficient? My answer would be no. Why? Because the Queen's Park Savannah is a very big place. And it could be anywhere in the Queen's Park Savannah. So guys, thank you for tuning in to our English lesson today. And thank you to all those who have been tuning in regularly to GT Lessons. I hope you guys have a great evening and enjoy the rest of your day and weekends.
GT Lessons, brought to you courtesy Dairy Dairy, the Milky Milk, and Frito-Lay Good Fun. You're watching CNC3. The views and opinions expressed in the following program are not necessarily those of CNC3.
For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. plans to give you hope and a future. You are now tuning into the program, Strong Nation, with your host, Pastor Marcos.
Arise and shine. May the power of God rest on you. May the blessings of God be made available to you. I would like to say a prayer to all of you watching us right now, because this is what we are going to be doing every single day in the special broadcasts of the Universal Church of the Kingdom of God right here in CNC3. Why? Because we are complying with the past regulations of our government, and we are aware of the implications, how many people they are being troubled, how many people they are victims of this pandemic that has taken the world, that has brought chaos upon our nation. Because of it, we are going to be conducting prayer services right here, CNC3, to the comfort of your house, that you may be blessed. We are going to be sharing the word of God. We are going to be praying for you. We are going to be ministering unto you so that your life may change. So 8:30 in the morning, every single day, Monday to Friday, Pastor Philip will be with you with the Beyond Limits program. 1 p.m., Pastor Junior will be with you with the Showdown of Faith, and I'll be with you with the Strong Nation. And we are going to have three services a day, 8:30, 1 p.m., and 5 p.m. If you cannot get to church, so the church will get to you. My God and Father, in the name of Jesus, I stretch my hands towards all those who are now with me, listening to me, watching this special broadcast. I ask you to touch them. I ask you to empower them. I ask you to sustain them. I ask you to perform a miracle in their lives. I ask you that right now, my Father, those who are worried, preoccupied, troubled, in anguish, in pain, in distress, this person may be released. This person may be set free. May this program, oh God, bring light, hope, power, strength, renewal, revival, solution to those who are watching it. With a blessing, I bless them all. And I determine that your power be manifested in their lives. And those who agree say, amen. Lives are being transformed in the Universal Church of the Kingdom of God. And I'm going to show you now the life of a person, this young lady called Janelle. I was with her in the interview room, and she was telling us how her life used to be. But when she was filled with the Holy Spirit, everything changed. Let us watch.
We're now watching Strong Nation.
Very good day to you and welcome to our interview room. I am here with Janelle. Miss Janelle, how are you today?
I'm good.
Nice to have you here.
Thank you.
She's going to be sharing her story with us. She's going to be telling us how her life was and later on how her life became. Miss Janelle, tell us, how was life before?